showed up and spoke out when Texas Republicans passed the most extreme abortion ban in the country. But Henry Cuellar sided with them, the lone Democrat against a woman's right to make her own decisions, even opposing life-saving care.
So that is an ad, portion of an ad from Jessica Cisneros targeting Henry Cuellar, who is, and it can't be said enough, a Democrat in office being supported by the Democratic establishment that does not want you to have the right to choose. He agrees with the Republicans. He has voted with the Republicans on this. For all we know, he is celebrating with the Republicans as they cruise towards getting rid of Roe v. Wade. And the issue is that Nancy Pelosi, Clyburn, and other Democratic leaders are putting, they're not just tolerating him. They're not just allowing it. They're not just staying neutral in the primary where he is facing a progressive challenger who believes in reproductive freedoms. They are putting their political capital, time, and money on the line to keep Cuellar in office. Now, we've already gone over in multiple videos Cuellar's positions on this, his prior votes on this. There is a little bit of new reporting in this area, though, that we want to make sure you know. So go back to August of 2018. Kristie Small was newly serving as the acting chief of staff for Henry Cuellar when she told him she was pregnant. Small requested maternity leave via email, and Cuellar responded that they would need to talk about the leave and the 90-day probationary period for all new hires. Now, she had never heard about this probationary period, and it wasn't in the employee handbook. Cuellar went on to not approve her parental leave, and October 16th, he fired her over the phone, citing poor job performance. She was the acting chief of staff, and he fired her over the phone. Anyway, she was in her third trimester. 2 weeks later, she delivered her baby at 30 weeks pregnant. It was a stillbirth. So a tragedy in multiple different areas. Now, she filed a lawsuit against Cuellar's office the following May, alleging both sex and pregnancy discrimination under federal law, and noting that she'd worked for a different congressman for 13 years without any performance issues. Cuellar's office tried to dismiss the lawsuit on summary judgment and submitted letters from her colleagues about her job performance. But according to court documents, Cuellar himself requested that the staffers write these letters after he had fired Small, and at least five were dated after she filed her lawsuit. So months and months after she was fired, the judge, by the way, said perhaps Cuellar was simply looking for corroboration of Small's poor performance, but a jury might also see this as an attempt to collect post hoc justifications, which is 100% what it was. He isn't just ideologically opposed to it. He seems to find pregnancy a real inconvenience, a fireable offense. And then he will try to cover his tracks like 6 months afterward to justify throwing this woman to the curb because she inconveniently for him became pregnant, yes.
Yeah, well, I guess I agree with him there. Pregnancy is a huge inconvenience for not just the women who are involved, but for the men who are involved. And we always, in this debate, we always forget that there is always a man that is involved, right? Women don't just get pregnant on their own. But Cuellar, he's kind of known around Texas, around these parts, as a pretty well-known dino, right? Most of his positions lean Republican, but the district that he serves is right outside of San Antonio, and it goes all the way down to the Texas border. It's a blue district, right? People forget that we have those here in Texas, but we definitely do. As a Republican, it's unlikely that he would have won that district. So now you have a progressive candidate who actually does uphold all the values of the blue people, the people who are voting blue, right? People who want a Democratic leader. She is giving them, offering them all those things. And she didn't lose by very much in the last election, yeah, right? It was like a frustratingly close election. I think she lost by not even 3,000 votes in the district, which is not very much. But hopefully this year she has more press behind her. I've seen her a lot more in national news stories, not just here in Texas. I think she's getting a lot more donations, I want to say. I haven't checked lately, but last I did see is a lot of people from around the country, not just in her district and not just in Texas, are donating to her campaign. And it really is unfair, especially whenever this guy is still upholding these anti-abortion stances, even since the leak of Roe v. Wade, and Nancy Pelosi is still supporting him. She keeps saying that she just, you know, bar none backs the incumbent, but we also know that that isn't true. She's inconsistent there. So her, and even if that is the reason, then what is her endorsement worth, right? If all she does is just back whatever, whoever the incumbent is, that's not much of an endorsement.
Yeah, which is, by the way, is how she would label her endorsement strategy, so that we like trying to disarm criticisms of who she tries to endorse. But that, of course, isn't the case. She throws it behind certain incumbents and not others. She's not off like, she's not helping Ilhan Omar like right now. Like, she's involved in certain ones. And I hope Cisneros is doing everything she can. There's a lot of money that's floating in on the other side. It should, I think it does look, it should look terrible for Nancy Pelosi that she is spending this time after the leak, like rallying for this guy. But the issue is, who's talking about it? Mainstream media, are they asking her constant questions about this? Are former Pelosi supporters getting fired up on Twitter? Why of all times to support this guy? How about you go behind Cisneros? She's an actual Democrat and supports reproductive freedom. You can't, but again, they just, it just never materializes. They don't talk about it. She's not gonna face any tough questions about it. There's not gonna be a press conference. She and Clyburn can just endorse this guy and then move on.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.